All right, let me take a bite and show you what it looks like on the inside. Hello and welcome to In the Kitchen with Matt. I am your host, Matt Taylor. Today, I'm going to show you how to make homemade crispy fried chicken. Oh yeah, I love fried chicken. I had a request to make some fried chicken, so here we go. That's what we're going to do. Really easy to do. If I can do it, you can do it. Before I move on, make sure to subscribe to my channel, hit that notification bell so you won't miss out on any of my new videos. Also, if you found this video helpful, do a thumbs up for me. It'll really help me out. Let's get started. All right. I have about 3 pounds worth of chicken here, and I am using a mixture of drumsticks and thighs. Bone in, skins on, oh yeah. And now we want to take buttermilk. It's about 2 cups worth. And let's get that chicken in that buttermilk. And then I'm going to put my lid on, or do like plastic wrap or something. We're gonna pop this in the fridge, and we're gonna let it soak or marinate or brine for at least 4 hours, up to like 24 hours. The longer you do it, the more flavor that's gonna be put into the chicken from the buttermilk. If you're in a hurry, you can just let the chicken soak for about 30 minutes and then just go from there. It'll still taste pretty good that way. So about 30 minutes before you wanna start frying up your chicken, put your oil in a pot like a Dutch oven, or also you could just use a skillet or a cast iron skillet, something like that. And you want it to be a couple inches deep. If you're using a shallow skillet, you can do it in about a 1 inch deep oil as well. Now we're gonna put this on the stovetop and set the heat to medium. And we wanna heat this up to about 375 degrees. Because once we put the chicken in, it's gonna bring the oil temp down to our ideal temp, which is between 300 and 325 degrees Fahrenheit, right around 160 Celsius. And now while the oil is heating up, let's create our flour dredge. I have 3 cups of flour here, 2 tablespoons of salt, about a half tablespoon of garlic powder, about a half tablespoon of paprika, about a tablespoon and a half of ground pepper. And if you want some heat, then you're going to add some cayenne pepper, maybe about a half a tablespoon of cayenne pepper to a tablespoon of cayenne pepper. Also, you could add hot sauce to your buttermilk and chicken beforehand. Now with a whisk, let's go ahead and whisk this up. You don't have to be too crazy with it, because we're going to take that and put it in a Ziploc bag. All right, cool. Boom, set this aside. All right, now what we want to do is we want to grab a piece of chicken, and you want to just kind of wiggle off some of that excess buttermilk and then put it right into your bag of flour mixture. Okay. And then just take it and shake it, okay? And then just kind of grab a piece, shake off the excess, and put it down on a silicone or parchment paper lined sheet pan or something like that. All right, so I have my pot over here on the stove. Got my little candy thermometer in there so I can get the oil to the right temp. Now I'm using canola oil. You can use vegetable oil. You could use peanut oil. Lard is a good choice. Anything that has a high heat content. All right, our oil is heated up, and now we are going to take our chicken and put it in and then let it fall away from you. And we don't want to crowd it too much, so I'm only going to put about 3 drumsticks in there and maybe a 4th one. And the drumsticks will take anywhere from 12 to 16 minutes or so
We want the internal temperature to be at least 165 degrees. And if you see the oil is going below your temp, you can just turn the heat up a little bit. If the oil is too hot, just put in some extra oil to cool it down or turn the heat down. I do have an electric deep fryer, which is really nice because it shows your temperature digitally and real easily to keep at the right temp. And if you are using just a skillet, then you are gonna wanna come in and turn the chicken. Occasionally, to make sure each side gets equally cooked. If you want an extra thick crust around the chicken, then what you'll do is after you dip it in the flour, then you'll go into make an egg wash with some egg and some water, and then dip it in there, and then back into the flour one more time so it's double coated. All right, take a look. These look great. I'm gonna take them out. They were in for 12 minutes and put them on a wire rack. Or you can put them on a plate with like paper towel. Now I wanna show you the difference between a double dredge and just a single dredge. So I had I put a couple eggs in there with some water, about 2 tablespoons of water and 2 eggs. And then I'll take my thigh here. We'll go into the egg mixture. Egg wash. And then let the excess come off into our bag. And we'll get it nice and coated again. And then back into our oil. All right, all the chicken is done. And then you're just gonna let it sit and cool a little bit because it's really hot to eat into it. These ones right here, I double dredged, and these were the single dredged, so they look a little bit different. All right, let me take a bite and show you what it looks like on the inside. Perfectly done, nice and moist. Oh my goodness, yummy. And there we have it. Fried chicken. Pretty easy to do. If I can do it, you can do it. I'm Matt Taylor. This has been another episode of In the Kitchen with Matt. Thank you for joining me. As always, if you have any questions, comments, or requests, put them down below and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. Thumbs up, down the corner, push it. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and check out my other videos. Take care. Time for me to dive into this. Oh yeah. I'm gonna grab this one right here on the top. Oh.